praises who I am. I will praise him while I can. I'll bless him at all times. And I vow to praise you through the good and the bad. This is my testimony in all that I go through. Somebody said, why? I said, because praise is what I do. So the devil will hear you. Praise is who I am. Come and praise the Lord.
Praise him while I can.
I bless him
at
all times. And I bless.
And I vow to praise you
through the good,
doing a good job practicing y'all organizational skills.
Yeah, over here through the cream
tea. Oh. Okay. Dang, all these cream trees though.
It's on the shelf.
What shelf?
In our
coffee mate. Yeah. That ass, Nick. You didn't have to do the freezing, right?
Mm-mm.
Let's see how freeze look.
Not good.
Let's see. It don't look bad. Don't look bad.
How about you?
Hey, you got it done, Rain. Let's see. There you go. Your refrigerator. The nice Rain. White. Set up. Say hey to the peeps.
Hey.
How you feel? 1 through 10.
I say 8.
Man, you was an 8 like a week ago, 2 weeks ago.
I'm okay. A 9 in.
Yeah, something.
When everything come together, I'll
right.
be 10. But today, I feel an 8.5.
You feel an 8.5. I can't see your face. You feel an 8.5.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to show them your mouth, huh? You don't want the whole world to see your mouth. They got to look. Oh, they don't want to see that.
Nah,
I don't want to show that either.
I
know you ain't ashamed. Pillow. What you playing, Shan?
Call of Duty.
Did y'all vacuum y'all room today?
Yes, yep.
Cause there's stuff right there.
Where?
Right there. Shan, move that mask.
Oh,
I'ma throw it away.
What mask?
10:20. Crock pot still going.
Yo.
I put the clock right here. I kind of probably put it up too high, but it's okay. I bought some new towels. The Sonny, he organized it and everything. Bought this one, and I got this one. Who did that? So yeah, I just did a little something. I might get another rug. I don't know. Who did that closet though? I'm gonna eat my watermelon today. Okay, the hubby put together the Sunny bookcase, and let's go to desk. Here go his other stuff and everything. Yeah. I just bought this to keep stuff in, my little personal stuff. Yeah, and I went to Dollar Tree and I got some little containers and stuff for his room. So yeah, I got this and I ordered these off of Amazon. I got 2 white ones and 6 boom. Yeah, I gotta finish putting these in. So in that. So one thing I gotta do is do that. And child number 6. The hubby had to move this right here because child number 6, she need to come back for a minute. And I got his pillow. And this is what I got, my nail lamp for the cure, my rhinestones. It's upstairs though. But yeah, we here went through all of this and then I reorganized this. They'll be keeping stuff organized and everything. Paper plates and stuff, we store it up here. So yeah, Yep. And everything, you know, I overflow the food right here. And everything. So, I just went grocery shopping. So we got this, got some Italian beefs, this stuff, and potato tots, a turkey, and the hubby be eating on this, and this gonna fuck me right there. So yeah. Wing sections. I don't eat this. The kids eat this. So I organize this too. Yeah, so that's that. And we put the other toast that was in there. The hubby moved them around. They're my grandbaby's car seats. So yeah. I have to wash my camera. I have to wash these towels. These came out the Sunny Bear from, and this is sheet set. Yeah. All this off of Amazon. I got him this letter. Gene, I'm gonna spray paint it. Probably navy blue. This gonna go over his bed. So I got everything now. And I got a little new rug. Look like the same one he got, but I don't know. I really do. But that one. And I got the mirror still there. So. Hey, peeps. How you doing today? You doing good? That's good. I feel that. I have to, it don't run by battery. I have to charge it up. So it's time for it to get charged because it's not blowing as fast as it usually blow. So, but it got three settings. So I got it on the first setting. All right, let's see. Which one? That's all. Okay. Come back on. Okay. Huh. Oh, vibrating. I put it back on the first one. So, y'all enjoyed y'all weekend? That's good. I enjoy mine too for the most part. So today is Sunday. February, y'all know I ain't gonna know the date on no Sunday. Today the 9th?
Yeah.
Oh, today is February the 9th, Sunday at 12:40 in the p.m. So, y'all, I've been recording my day all morning, so. Y'all know, I got up at 6:30 to get my crock pot meal going, which I'm fixing some crock pot ribs, some spaghetti, and probably open up a can of sweet peas or string beans. I got both in a can. I'll see. And that's that. So around 3 o'clock, it should be done to 3:30 or whatever. And I just not too long got revealed mopping. This my week starts Sunday. I have to reveal mop this week. We reveal mop twice in a week. And so it's my week. Normally I do it in the evening, but I went on and done and got it over with because my floors was really dirty. So I just did that. And I showed y'all, Rain cleaned the refrigerator out. This was her day to clean the refrigerator out. She did a real good job. I showed y'all the sun stuff. So I went to Dollar Tree yesterday and got some beans and stuff because I don't know how I'm organizing. But I just want to make sure I had enough stuff or whatever.
And yeah, that's what I did. And I put some lip gloss, my little shiny lip gloss on, and I had ended up putting a lot on my finger. I wasn't paying attention, but I'm like, oh well. Ain't gotta worry about it coming off. And my hair still hanging in there, y'all. I don't know, I think it's been about a month. So, yeah. I'm like, okay, hair. Excuse me. And what else? And how we finally finished Dexter last night. Wow, 8 seasons. We finished it. It was good. A lot, my hubby, they don't like how it ended, but I don't care, dog. It was just good to me anyway. So, of course, I'm going to like the ending because I like the every episode anyway. So, we finally finished that. We still watching The Queen of the South, and we watch some Vikings. I like the Vikings. That's good. So, I don't know what we're going to watch since we finished watching Dexter because normally we replace it with something else. We'll figure it out. Throat. So, I guess that's about it, peeps. I can't really think of too much because I'm kind of tired. Yeah, I'm tired, y'all. Got up early and been going to bed late. I think we went to bed around close to 1 o'clock this morning. We finished Dexter out. Then I got up at 6. I got up at 5 to use the bathroom. Then I just laid there for a little while, not back off, but I knew I didn't want to go into no deep sleep, so I wouldn't let myself fall all the way back to sleep. I knew I needed to get up early and get them ribs going so they could be tender. At least by the time we eat dinner or whatever, so yeah. So, y'all ready for a read? Let's get into this read. Oh. I ordered that G off of Amazon. I'm gonna just spray paint it, put it over his bed. So far I feel like I got everything. But once I start putting everything together, if I see I might want to get something else, I could just pick that up or order it on Amazon. But the biggest part is done, refreshing. Like new sheets, comforter, pillow. The curtain's good. Waste basket, lamp good. That mirror run right, so got that. The rug is kind of like dingy like, so I got that. got on the desk and stuff to keep it more organized. Take them other little tables out so it won't be so much in there. And the hubby put the bookcase together yesterday. So we'll bring it up when I'm ready to. That'll be the last thing, probably. So, yeah, what else did I show you? I think I did a haul Thursday when I went out. So, y'all to see footage of that stuff that I got Thursday. So, yeah, I don't want this video too long, y'all. So, let's get on into this read. Y'all just bear with me today, because I'm sounding all, because that's exactly how I feel. It's been a weekend. I tell you the truth. So, here we go. Oh, it's a real short read, so, okay, let's do this. God, okay, we're talking about, I'm going to always have to go back to this part so it won't just seem like I'm just reading anything. You said, when you invite the Holy Spirit of God to work in you, you cannot help. You cannot keep your own transformation from happening. God knows you and see your potential. God knows everything about you. How great is that? Okay, here we go. Y'all ready for this read? God knows your future. You are not an accident. It doesn't matter who your parents were or what they did. Amen. You are not a surprise to God. Woo! Do I need to reread that? God knows your future. You are not an accident. It doesn't matter who your parents were or are. I add the R. Or what they did or doing. You are not a surprise to God. And your future is planned. You formed my inward parts. You covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise you. For I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Ooh, marvelous are your works. And that my soul knows very well. In your book, they all were written. The days fashioned me. The days fashioned for me. When as yet there were none of them. That's in the book of Psalms 139, verses 13, 14, and 16. If the future God has for you is written in God's book already, then the only one who can keep it from happening is you. Woo! Okay? Doesn't that make you feel that God cares about you and you're not just wandering alone through life? Wow, I got her done. That was good. Because that's exactly what had to happen with me. Doesn't that make you feel, it's a feeling that God cares about you and you're not just wandering alone through life. He is with you always. He will never leave you nor forsake you. And I found comfort in that because people, y'all know how people do. They go off, they just go. They live their life, you know. And for those that, you know, we have the ones that have children and everything, you know, God bless us, open our womb to have babies and raise them. And they go off and to live their life. And that's part of the circle of life that's supposed to happen. You know, that's just, you know, we just get used to having them up under us. And that's the mother part of us and everything, the emotional part of us. But we have to let them go just like our mothers, our parents had to let us go. But they go, you know, but God is always there. When you feel lonely or when you just feeling by yourself, that's why it's good to seriously have a relationship with your Heavenly Father, the one that created you, formed you in your mother's womb. He know you from top to bottom. He know him when you was being knitted together and all of that. You know, we have our best friends and our, you know, people that we talk to here on earth and everything, you know, that God probably placed in our life. But who better to really talk to that know you more better than you know yourself and everything, and that can, like, whatever situation you having going on, whether it's, you know, a depression state or just a lonely state, he could be your friend and everything. Whether you just sad and you mourning and you grieving, he could be your comforter, you know, and, you know, just your doctor. It's so many things that our Heavenly Father / Jesus, his son, can be for us. When nobody else can really be all of that for us. People can listen, you know, but healing. You could get healed from things, not just ailments, but from mental things, emotional things. See, God can go all the way down up in there, you know, because he been seeing you. He knew you when you was being formed in your mother's womb. You go talk to people, they got to ask you questions to get to know you. Our Heavenly Father don't need to ask us nothing. Anything. We need to listen to what he has to tell us about us, you know, so we can become the better version of us and to do what he have called us to do. You know what I'm saying? Because he know our future. It's just things that got to take place, steps a process to get there. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I really liked it, that read and everything. So, that was really good. I hope y'all enjoyed that as well. Okay, God knows your future. When we be sitting up here, you know, planning and whatever we do about the next week, the next month, the next year, God already know if that's going to come to pass or not. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes even the next day, sometimes the next minute or hour, because you can get a knock and a phone call and just throw your whole day off, you know? So he knows your future, and the future ain't always like 5 or 6 years down the road. Your future can be the next minute, because you ain't got that yet. It could be the next second, you know, it could be the next day, it could be the next month and everything. So he knows all of that. And I'm saying, like, to fam, you found comfort. I found comfort in knowing that I serve the one who knows all of that. And I'm good. You get what I'm saying? It don't even matter. I'm good, and whatever he allowed to come in my life, I'm still going to be good. Regardless of the type of emotions I'm going to feel about a thing, I know I'm going to come out good. Get what I'm saying? So, yeah, because he already knew this was coming. He saw this coming. And sometimes when you got a relationship, he'll even prepare you for a thing. You might not even know what that thing going to be, but something could be doing. He could be doing something inside of you, strengthening you and everything, and having you going through something right now to prepare you for this thing that's coming in your future, which could be tomorrow. You know? So, yeah. When you got the Holy Spirit in you, he could drop it just like that. So, that was good, basically. Yeah, I be me and my eyeballs, y'all. I think it'd be this heat. Be drying everything out. The air just be dry. Got my eyeballs dry, my nose dry, my throat dry. Okay, so that's it, y'all. I got them done. And again, I hope y'all enjoyed that. And of course, my input, my insight, and everything. I've been trying not to. I have to cut myself short, because I could, when I feel it and get wound up, I'm gone, y'all. I'm ready to talk about this, that, and the other, and everything. So I have to, like, pull myself back. Like, come on. Okay, that's enough. That's enough. You done gave enough. Okay? So, yeah. And so let me get on out of here and... I basically done got everything done around maybe 3 o'clock. I fixed my spaghetti and opened up my string beans or sweet peas. I don't know which one I'm gonna do. We just had string beans, so I might do the sweet peas and everything. I like string beans. I used to love sweet peas, but I like string beans more than sweet peas. Why is you standing? Y'all see her?
I had sweet potato yesterday.
Oh, yeah, we ate some jerk yesterday for dinner.
Yeah, I had jerk tilapia and sweet potatoes and fries.
You had jerk tilapia, sweet potato, and fries. Was it 1 through 10? How was it?
10 in my toes.
10 fingers and 10 toes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and Rain had, what Rain had?
She had.
Huh, Georgie had the same thing. Jerk.
Macaroni.
Jerk chicken. Mm-hmm. And macaroni and fries. And I had...
And bread. Yummy bread.
Oh, yeah. I didn't even eat the bread, but I heard it was good. It was I went to a jerk restaurant, and I had jerk chicken. I liked that sauce.
Me too.
I liked that jerk sauce. I had jerk chicken with cabbage and macaroni. That macaroni was real good.
No.
Oh, that's how you feel about it. Okay. And the hubby... He ain't eat nothing.
Papa don't have teeth.
He don't have teeth. You heard that, babe? She putting you on blast. She said, Papa didn't eat because he don't got teeth. You will be back. I'll be back. He got to get him some dentures. That smoking life, y'all. That smoking life. tear it up in there, eat it all up. But yeah, all right. She didn't want to put her input in and talk about her yummy dinner she had yesterday. She was trying something different, and it was really, really good. So I be trying to move around on Saturdays because this was my week to cook. So normally I try to go out to the restaurant, pick up something different. Yeah, last weekend we had Taco Bell. So yeah, but I can eat that every Saturday though because I love tacos. So yeah, and on that note, y'all, I'm out. I hope everybody have a blessed Monday, a safe Monday, a productive Monday. Get her done. And have a protective Monday / Tuesday / Wednesday / Thursday. And I see y'all back at the table on Friday. All the hubby got to go back to the dentist. They got to do another extraction. So it takes him like about Friday. No, he ain't no good Friday and Saturday. Sunday he be a little bit. But I noticed like about Wednesday, Tuesday, he start feeling a lot better. Wednesday, I think he be like good. But so I'm just trying to buy him soups. I bought him some grits. I bought bananas. I got him some protein shakes, some electric like water. Just different things that since he can't really and everything to still keep him hydrated and get him his nutrients, and plus he take vitamins and all of that. So for the most part, yeah, he did pretty good, and his gums healing pretty good. So yeah, two more sessions and he'll be done, and then they'll make his dentures, and that's gonna take a minute, and that's when they're gonna be real. So on that note, I'm out, y'all. Peace, love, share some, and what? Holla. Bye, y'all. Y'all waiting on that wall, right? Yeah. I was watching the movie and I saw the word because I like captions on the TV screen. Because sometimes I can't be understanding what they be saying. And I saw the word. I saw that word, whoa, and they spelled the WHOAE. I'm like, it's been around forever. So why not just put a little swag to it, right? Oh, whoa. Bye, y'all. K-Classic.
Stopping my shine. They try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus.